for our next speaker, we have Dr. Supaporn Wacharaplasty from the Thai Red Cross Emerging Infectious Disease Health Science Center in Thailand, who's going to speak on multi-sectoral engagement in the COVID-19 outbreak response in Thailand. So, Dr. Supaporn, over to you.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. My name is Supaporn Wacharaplasty. I'm working for the Thai Red Cross Emerging Infectious Disease Health Science Center at King Chulalongkorn Memorial Hospital and the Faculty of Medicine, Chulalongkorn University, based in Bangkok, Thailand. And thank you for giving me the opportunity to share the experience from Thailand on the multi-sectoral engagement in the COVID-19 outbreak response. For success of the COVID-19 early detection and control, in my responsibility, I think integration of the three D's, like I show you here. The first D is the research and development, that the knowledge that we gain from research can strengthen the discovery to for the early detection, and then we can have the prompt diagnosis later. So I will show you how these three D's can integrate together and have a really good success for COVID-19 detection and control in Thailand. Let's start with the early detection part. The national level of laboratory network during the early detection among three partners, including Department of Disease Control, Department of Medical Science, and the academic that from Chulalongkorn University and also the Thai Red Cross Society. These two organizations are in the same building, but just different name. Yep. And these three organizations working together for the early detection, and how we work, I will show you in the next few slides. And next, I would like to talk about the control. The expanding of the diagnostic laboratory network to the provincial level and the private laboratories with the 24 turnaround time of laboratory results, let the Department of Disease Control can respond promptly to investigate the contact cases. So this is make the better control and contain of the disease. And respond. The last but not least, for the research and development that can make a better response. For example, the research can strengthen the capacity and capability for the novel detection. For example, the USAID PREDICT project and the other DETRA funding to Thailand that strengthen our capability and capacity to cope with the emerging infectious disease. And the other example is the surveillance of the SARS-CoV-2 variants in Thailand. That is the national multi-sectoral collaboration among Ministry of Public Health and the private hospitals and the academic research center. And the last one that I will show you today is the research on the origin of the SARS-CoV-2 in bat. That is a collaboration with among the government partner, Department of National Parks, Wildlife and Plant Conservation, Kasei Sad University, and Chulalongkorn University. Let me show you the example of the one research project called PREDICT that was supported by USAID since 2010 to 2019. It's a long-term project, 10 years. the project is implemented in at the 31 hotspots countries, including Thailand. It aims to strengthen the capacity of the country to especially on the sampling and also the laboratory capacity to detect the novel viruses. So we gain a lot of experience from the PREDICT project. And this is the diagnostic approach that PREDICT used for detection of the new and known viruses. It called family-wide PCR that used the consensus primer that brought amplification of multiple and genetically related, including the previous unidentified pathogens. That means we can detect both known and new viruses in the same PCR reaction. So, and this is some of the results during the past 5 years that we conduct the surveillance in wildlife animals and testing for 5 wildlife families, including coronavirus, paramyxovirus, flavivirus, influenza virus, and filoviruses. You can see that the heat map shows mostly in coronaviruses, and the positive samples mostly found in bats. So this is let me and my team learn about how to detect the novel coronaviruses from bat, and this knowledge turn for the to implement for detection of the novel coronavirus in human cases that I will show you later. The family-wide PCR is had been used for the MERS coronavirus discovery since 2012, and when in January last year, when the government asked my laboratory to detect the unknown virus, unknown pneumonia viruses, without any choice what they want to detect, so that I at that time I take the lessons from the MERS-CoV detection using the family-wide PCR together with the PREDICT protocol that I learned from coronavirus detection in bat. So, and then it's combined together, and this is the workflow that three national laboratories working together. The first group is at Bamla Naradun Infectious Disease Institute from Department of Disease Control. They're responsible for detected all known respiratory pathogens from the same sample. And the other two samples were sent to my laboratory at the Thai Red Cross Emerging Infectious Disease Center laboratory. I used the family-wide PCR for coronavirus and influenza virus and next generation sequencing. And at the National Laboratory, Department of Medical Science, they have their own testing for unknown pneumonia. So we kind of like have a different part, different protocols for detection the unknown pathogen when we don't know what it is. And this is the timeline of viral discovery of the first COVID-19 case in Thailand. In 8th of January, the specimen was positive by coronavirus family PCR. And when we sequenced, we got the sequence on January of 9. And when we merged to the GenBank, it showed just the bat cell-like coronavirus. It not matched to any human viruses at that time. So However, when 11 January, when China shared the data of virus that caused the unknown pneumonia in Wuhan, we reanalyzed again, and it's 100% match. So that is the time that why we quite sure that we found the same disease as in Wuhan. And on the next day, we conduct the next generation sequencing for whole genome sequence analysis at Department of Medical Science and at my laboratory. And the results from both lab confirmed that we have the same viruses, the same virus as found in Wuhan. And for the diagnostic networking, when it expands to all provinces, right now in Thailand, there are more than 200 laboratories in 76 provinces, and all the COVID-19 PCR results can be received within 24 hours. And we have the standard, reference laboratory for confirm all the new molecular laboratory that just set up for this last year for COVID-19 testing. And this is kind of the networking for the simple, for the remote laboratory and the reference laboratory working together for the detection and for the QC of the laboratory to make Thailand to let us get the result within 24 hours so that it's benefit for the rapid control the outbreak in our country. And the surveillance for SARS-CoV-2 variants is one example of the national multi-sectoral collaboration. So it is led by the national laboratory, but this table is the work that my center collaborate with the Department of Disease Control and also the private hospital, because right now we want to seek for the variants that come with the travelers to the airport. That's why we try to target the group from who travel abroad from the state quarantine from the hospital that receive the state quarantined patients. So, and on your right hand side is the data of the B1.351 that we got the specimen from state quarantine. This is a Thai man travel back from Tanzania, and we found this variant T51 by the collaboration with the government partner, yeah, and with the academic laboratory that work together, that we, and then we can report within 5 days after he came alive the airport. Next, let me switch the presentation to the other research in bat research, in bat study, the bat variants. This is the study that we want to see the origin of the SARS-CoV-2 virus in bats in Thailand. In Thailand, we have at least 72 of the horseshoe bat, which is you might know that the horseshoe bat had been reported by the colleague from Wuhan Institute of Virology in January last year, that there there is the SARS coronavirus related called RATG13 that show 96% nucleotide identity to the human SARS-CoV-2. So this species of bat called Linolophus affinis, it can found in south of China to Thailand, Cambodia, and Indonesia, something like this. This is the objective that we want to seek to find the SARS-CoV-2 related virus in our country. So that this is to fill the gap of the origin of the SARS-CoV-2 in animal. So, and this study was published a few weeks ago. This study is also the multi-sectoral collaboration internationally and nationally. So this co-led by Department of National Parks, Wildlife and Plant Conservation and Chulalongkorn University, and collaborate with the Kaseisat University and with the internationally collaboration with Duke NUS with the EAD program that led by Professor Lin Fa Wang. And we start our study in June last year. We went to the east of Thailand, and this is a team. We collect 100 of horseshoe bats at the cave and take the blood for serology surveillance, and take the letter swab for the PCR and genetic study. At this site, there is only one bat species called Linolophus acuminatus. This is different species to the China. And it is found in Brunei, Cambodia, Indonesia, Laos, Malaysia, the Philippines, and Thailand. And on your left hand side is the map showing the country that had been report of detection of the SARS-CoV-2 related virus in bat, including Japan, China, Cambodia, and in my study, Thailand. This is the result of the PCR from this is where the bat live. It's an artificial cave at the eastern of Thailand. 13 in 100 were positive by PCR, and when we sequenced for the RDRP gene with 290 base pair, it found that it's really closely to the human SARS-CoV-2 and the RATG13. But when we characterize for the whole genome sequence with almost 30,000 base pair, the percent identity is lesser to 91% to the human SARS-CoV-2, and with higher percent with the RMYN02 from China. And this is the phylogenetic tree of the complete genome, showing that the Thai RA203 virus from Thai horseshoe bat is the new member of the SARS-CoV-2 related coronavirus lineage. And this is the receptor binding function study of the Thai virus RAC203 with using the phylogenetic tree of the RBD gene, it's found that it belongs to the group called non-ACE2 usage that include YN02 and other Bat-Sach coronavirus compared to the ACE2 usage that is RATG13 and the human SARS-CoV-2 virus. And this is confirmed by the experiment, the binding experiment of the the pseudotype virus with the ACE2 luminex bead. And it found that our virus RAC203 and YN002 from China not bind to the ACE2, but SARS-CoV-2, the first and SARS coronavirus and RATG13 and pangolin IBD can bind to the ACE2. So this is confirmed that the Thai RAC203 not use the ACE2 for infection. That means it right now it's not harmful to the human. And we also conduct the zero surveillance of the COVID-19 in this study in bats and in pangolins. On your right hand pictures are the veteran from Department of Wildlife collect the blood from pangolin and the rectal swab from pangolin. And on the right hand is the team collecting the bat blood for ELISA testing. And this is show the ELISA testing for neutralizing antibody using the serogate virus neutralization test that was developed by Dr. Lin Fa lab at Duke NUS. On the left hand is the result of the bat serum, and the y-axis show the percent inhibition. You can see that from 89 sample, four bat serums were positive for the interaction with the SARS-CoV-2, the human IBD, and two of them has a really high titer, higher than 80% inhibition. And this is the PCR result that I already mentioned, to 13%. And on the right hand is the result of the pangolin serum. 1 in 10 of pangolin serum was positive against the SARS-CoV-2 IBD antigen using the SVNT ELISA test with very high percent similar to the bat serum. Yeah, and for the PCR, it all negative. And this table summarizes the percent identity of the SARS-CoV-2 related virus found in China, Cambodia, Japan, and Thailand, and also the ACE2 uses. Right now, you can see that only three of the viruses, one from bat from China, TG13, one from Japan, 0319, and one from pangolin that can interact with the ACE2. And from the bat study, I can say that the SARS-CoV-2 originated from bats, and the serology will be a key to do the frontline surveillance. And there are other There is a possibility that there are other SARS-CoV-2 related coronavirus circulating in these bats, and the neutralizing antibody reflects the past infection by another coronavirus, which may be genetically more closely related to the SARS-CoV-2 that we found with 91%, and we need to do more surveillance in the animals. And this is my last slide that I would like to conclude, that the multi-sectoral engagement impact to the sentinel surveillance, to the referral laboratory networking, to the data sharing, research networking, technology transfer, and the policy advisor. And I would like to thank my multi-sectoral partners and supporters in country, from the Ministry of Public Health, Department of Disease Control, Department of Medical Science, Gaseosa University, Department of National Parks, Wildlife and Plant Conservation, the partner from Duke NUS, Singapore, EcoHealth Alliance, Wuhan Institute of Virology, BTRP, USDETRA, USAID, FAO, WHO, and the Thai GAN Agency, the Thailand Research Fund, the NRCT, and NSTDA. All of these partners and funding supporters make the laboratory stronger enough to cope with the novel viruses. Thank you for your attention.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Superform.